You know, it seems like every year right around this time, some moron who doesn't know how to put out a campfire or some guy smoking a nice cancer stick in his convertible flicks it out the window and sets 97% of the world on fire. And while most of us are sitting on our couches watching this madness unfold on TV,
oh my God, babe, all of Australia and California are on fire. Hey, you wanna watch Price is Right?
There's a select few brave souls heading out to that fiery woodsy madness to save all the Bambis, bears, and romantic cabins that we love so much. So let's take a couple seconds to talk about the reasons why wildland firefighters deserve so much more respect than we give them. Most firefighters work the traditional 24-hour on, 48-hour off work schedule, but not wildland firefighters. They do something called a roll.
They see me rolling.
A roll is 14 straight 16-hour days doing all the things that no one in firefighting wants to do. You see, when most people think about wildland firefighting, they think about all the cool air tankers dropping off water and red anti-fire sparkly powder. But 99% of all wildland firefighting is done with a shovel. Yeah. A shovel. You see, firefighters need to create something called a fire line. A fire line is where they get rid of as much fuel source as possible so this giant fire can't continue its deadly path towards humanity. So they get rid of all the trees, shrubbery, crap on the ground, and whatever you threw out your window because you're a crappy human. But this involves digging into the ground 3 to 4 feet deep and as wide as 30 feet depending on the topography or the type of wood that's burning. And depending on the location of the fire, they may have to hike a few miles just to get to where they're gonna start doing work. I mean, could you imagine showing up in the morning and your boss says this?
Jim, thanks for coming in, buddy. The new office is about 1.5 miles up that mountain over there if you wanna go ahead and head up. And by the way, if you get eaten by a bear, it's not workman's comp.
But what makes wildland firefighting so incredibly dangerous, besides the obvious things like getting eaten by a bear or if Bambi finally decides to exact her revenge on humanity, wildland fires have an unlimited supply of oxygen and fuel, so they can grow to such incredible sizes that they can actually create their own weather patterns. That means that they are unbelievably unpredictable and can change direction at any point in time. And depending on the size of the fire and the fuel source, these fires can move as fast as a football field a second. What? But what I think's most impressive about these guys and girls is that at the end of the day of fighting fires and digging ditches, they're not going back to a nice comfy bed or a hotel room. They're laying their sleeping bags down on the same forest floor that they're there to protect, trying to get as much sleep as possible and waking up the next day and doing it again. So next time you're out, you see a wildland firefighter or you come across one on your Facebook or Instagram, take a second. Give them a little shout out. They deserve it.
Try to catch me howling at the moon.